I'm Ron Patterson with Utah State University Extension in Weber and Morgan counties. Weeds do not recognize property boundaries and are really everybody's problem. Today's weed warrior topic is Myrtle Spurge, or donkey tail. You may ask, why is he wearing those silly nitrile gloves? Well, the reason is because of this sap right here. All parts of the Myrtle Spurge are toxic or poisonous, and this sap is very attractive to children. They get that on their skin, it can cause some severe blistering and even blindness. So you want to keep this away from children and do not touch that sap. Keep that off from your skin. One of the biggest problems with spurge is that it escapes cultivation and gets out into our sensitive arid Utah environments, and we end up with a scourge of the spurge, and it outcompetes our native plants and is not useful for anything other than landscape. Livestock don't eat it, wildlife don't eat it, and so it just kind of is a real big problem out in the native environment of Utah. Spurge seedlings, just like these little tiny myrtle spurge, this is actually the best time to pull these up is when they're seedlings. Then you can get them before they send that taproot down. The myrtle spurge is a simple perennial, meaning that it doesn't really spread by roots, but it does have a taproot that goes down quite deep. And so in order to control it by digging it up, you need to take out as much of that taproot as you can. After you dig it up, be sure you bag it and throw it away. Don't compost it. Don't try to keep it around. Throw it away. The flower on myrtle spurge is really inconspicuous. It's this thing right in here. When this is flowering, what we think is a flower is actually these bracts. And they're a bright yellow color. These are a little bit spent, so they're kind of turning pink, but it's a bright yellow, bright color, and it's actually quite attractive. After flowering, the myrtle spurge forms this seed pod, and the seeds mature. Once they mature, the seed pod ruptures and spreads these seeds. It'll fling them out about 15 feet. It spreads predominantly by seed, so the key to control is to stop it from going to seed. The roots will reproduce, or they'll send off shoots, so if you dig that, you may have to dig it several years in a row. Those seeds will last about 8 years in the wild or out in nature, so it'll take several years of control to get this under control. Prevention is always the best control option that we have, and so if we're running ATV equipment out in the on the hills and things like that, be sure to clean it, especially if you've been in an area where there's some noxious weeds such as myrtle spurge. Myrtle spurge is not usually an issue in cultivated fields, and so you don't see it in hay. You don't really have to worry about whether or not you're feeding myrtle spurge seed to in your hay, but keep your equipment clean, keep your tools clean, and try to keep that seed from getting spread from one spot to another. Water is a pretty obvious way when you have this erosion coming down the hillside that myrtle spurge will follow that water, and you can see in these landscapes where it's escaped that it's come down the hill, and you can see the myrtle spurge kind of trailing out into the waterways. There are no known biological controls for myrtle spurge, and there really aren't any good cultural controls as well, so we're stuck with mechanical removal or with herbicides. Legally, you don't have to pull it out of your landscape, but it is illegal to propagate or sell myrtle spurge in the state of Utah. So if you keep it in your landscape, cut off the seeds and it won't spread, but it's not the best option in the world. The best option is just get rid of it. So if your non-herbicide options aren't working for you, then you can use glyphosate, which is a non-selective herbicide. It's Roundup, kills all. There's lots of names for glyphosate. Glyphosate is the common chemical name, but that works fairly well as a non-selective option. Homeowners can use a broadleaf weed control, such as 2,4-D or dicamba. You have to be careful using those products. If it's going to be over 85 degrees for the next 3 days after you spray it, it can volatilize and move to non-target plants, so you have to watch temperature. Out here in the range situation, in our sensitive arid environment, Plateau is a product that can be used to control myrtle spurge. And then for those who have pesticide applicator licenses, the Tordon 22K is another product, but you have to have a pesticide applicator's license in order to use that product. We can win this war against Myrtle Spurge. It'll take a concerted effort and several years to get these under control. So be a good neighbor. Be a weed warrior.